once upon a future time.
Mr. Crane, what are you doing out here all alone?
Mm-hmm. Ah, Cadet Eagle. Just enjoying the view.
But what are you staring at? There's nothing out there.
Where some see nothing, others see everything. The sun sets and the moon rises, its gravitational pull gently tugging at the ocean waves.
Oh, the moon makes those waves? I see it now. Awesome! Oops, gotta go now, sir. It's supper time, and I can feel this cafeteria's gravity gently tugging at my fuel tank. The eagle has landed, and he's got a need to feed. Ew! Sour! What is this, Ava?
Persimmon.
What in the universe is a persimmon?
Persimmons are an edible fruit high in vitamin C and calcium.
Hey, guys!
Hey, darling! Rhubarb!
Persimmon? Rhubarb? With all our advanced technology, you'd think someone could dream up better flavors.
I hate to admit it, Eagle, but you're right. Somebody should talk to Headmaster Crane about it.
Who?
Who what?
Who's gonna talk to Headmaster Crane about getting some new fuel flavors around here?
How should I know?
You know, it would be great to have someone to represent our students in Space Academy. A kind of class president or something.
President?
Yes! Someone who has everyone's best interests at heart. We need...
Eagle! Absolutely! I'd be honored to serve as class president.
I was gonna say elections. You know, where everybody votes.
Votes?
Sure, for their favorite candidate.
Why do we need an election?
Because it's the only fair way.
Why don't we just ask the other kids who they want? Hey, gang, who would you vote for?
Vote for Eagle!
Vote for Eagle! Vote for Eagle!
Sheesh. So, according to my calculations, I could be an excellent president.
You're gonna run against Eagle?
I don't know. After all, he is our best friend, when he isn't being difficult.
Hey, guys, I brought you some campaign signs. Nice, huh? And listen to my slogan. Get on the winning team. Eagle's team.
What makes you so sure you're gonna win?
Well, who's gonna run against me?
Maybe I will.
You? Look, Robyn, you're great. I mean, you're smart, organized, well-respected. But a president needs to be popular and really cool. You know, like me.
True, you are popular. But maybe what a president really needs is some good ideas. Like mine.
Well, okay. Let's run against each other. This will be fun. I wonder who the voters will pick.
Vote for Eagle! Vote for Eagle!
Vote for Eagle!
Vote for Eagle!
Hawk, how many new fuel flavors do you think the ships will want?
Oh, I don't know. A zillion?
Hawk, that's crazy. There aren't a zillion flavors in the whole universe. According to my calculations, I think I can safely promise 5.
Oh, excuse me, Robyn. Eagle wants me. He's my friend, too. Eagle, you called?
Yeah. You've been over at Robyn's.
Uh-huh.
So, what is she promising?
5 new flavors of fuel.
Great! We'll promise a zillion!
Oh, but Robyn says... Gotta go!
So, What's Eagle up to?
He's gonna promise us a zillion flavors of fuel!
A zillion? But that's crazy!
Robin says that's crazy!
Crazy good, you mean?
According to my calculations, we can ask for 2 extra weeks more summer vacation.
A new moon house on the club base.
Huh?
Maybe she said a new club base on the moon house? A new moon club on the house base? A new club sandwich on the moon?
And a beautiful new clubhouse on the moon base. And that's why I'd make the best Space Academy student president.
That was great, Robin. Great. But as your president, I think a lot bigger. 5 new fuel flavors? Why not a zillion? 2 weeks more vacation? How about 2 months? And a little bitty clubhouse on the moon? Forget about it. Jupiter has at least 66 moons. Saturn has 62. Even Mars has 2. How about our very own second moon?
Congratulations, Eagle. You were right. It was no contest.
Thanks, Robin. You ran a great campaign. But there can only be one winner. No hard feelings, right?
No, not at all. So, what are you gonna do first?
Do first?
You know, a zillion flavors, new moon.
You mean I have to actually do that stuff?
Of course.
Oh. Well, no problemo. Excuse me, I've gotta go lasso a new moon.
Eagle. According to my calculations, giving Earth another moon could be a big mistake.
Don't worry about it. The moon is like a big asteroid, a chunk of rock revolving around the Earth. I just have to find a smaller asteroid and nudge that baby into place. One new moon coming right up. Whoa! I don't want you to get stuck going around Mars. There we go. Sweet! The Eagle has landed. Say hello to Mini Moon.
Headmaster Crane to control room. Headmaster Crane to control room.
Eagle! We've got a problem. The moon affects the oceans on Earth. Your mini-moon is making bigger waves.
Yeah, I know. Hear the cheering?
No, Eagle. We are talking about real waves. Huge waves. Rising sea levels.
Huh?
Remember what we spoke about? The moon's gravity tugs at Earth's oceans, creating high tides.
Sure, I remember that.
The problem is the asteroid you put in orbit around the Earth has gravity too. And that extra gravity is now pulling water levels even higher. That's what's making the waves. Giant waves.
If you had listened to me, none of this would have happened.
If I had listened to you, I would have lost the election.
So, Mr. President, what are you gonna do now?
Well...
We must remove that asteroid from Earth's orbit, and quickly.
Sea levels continue to rise.
Control to Eagle. Come in, Eagle.
Roger, Control.
How you doing up there, kid?
I've been pushing this baby for the last 10 minutes. It won't budge.
It is very easy to move something into Earth's orbit, but to remove it from orbit, very, very hard.
I could really use some help.
If we all push together, our combined force should be enough to move this asteroid out of Earth's orbit. Right, Headmaster?
That is correct, Cadet.
Okay, all together now.
Push. pushing, push, good.
Sea level returning to normal. Danger has been averted.
Oh, now that was a close call.
Vote for Robyn! Vote for Robyn! Vote for Robyn!
Vote for Robyn!
Eagle, what are you doing?
Getting you elected president. With my busy racing schedule and all, I don't really have time to run the school.
Really?
Yeah. Anyway, you'll make a better president than me. You know more stuff. And you don't care about being popular. Not that you're not popular.
Okay, Eagle. According to my calculations, you should stop talking right about now.
Vote for